Jay Shrek. You know, we're at AGUA FRIA National Monument. We're in the state of Arizona, going up the 17, you know, about 40 minutes from Phoenix, if you're not familiar. And we're in an area that is a national monument because of all of the historical sites and the ancient sites that are here. And it's just a beautiful place to ATV, UTV, any kind of off-road stuff you want to do. There's not much better. And we're here to test and see how well these bikes are going to work out up here. You know, I've ridden all kinds of different vehicles, from electric bikes to off-road vehicles, Toyota 4Runners. And we're going to run this motorcycles up here today and see how it works out. You know, one of the things we're also looking at today is we have two KLX 300s. We have one that's bone stock, and we have one that's pretty well modified, not to the degree that I'm finished with it, but we're going to see, you know, what is the real difference between running two of these bikes out here, one being completely stock, one stock, and then one with all these ads. I mean, is there really going to be that big a difference between these two vehicles with all the mods, even though I have to agree that I like how cool it looks, but is it really going to make my riding experience a lot better or more funner, or, you know, what is it really going to equate to in the long run? And we're going to find that out today. We're going to go out in AGUA FRIA. We're going to see some ancient stuff, some of the coolest stuff you'll ever see anywhere in the Southwest. And so here we are, and get ready for this journey. It should be an exciting day today. I can't wait. It's going to be so much fun. I'm really stoked about coming out here today. How's that horn work, Art?
Works awesome.
That is a great horn. That's a stock horn. That's a joke.
I was waiting to hear the next one.
Okay, so here we go. I wonder how this will work out. It's got two dead cats on the bike. We'll see how that works out. I've got a helmet on, which I've never had. No helmets, but I got it. Look where we're going, Art. Look at how beautiful that is. That's where we're heading. My glasses do not want to fit in this helmet. I'll say that much. So let's get on the road and let's see how this thing works out. This cobbled up microphone system I've got. We got plenty of water, we got cameras, we got fuel. Should have everything we need to start this journey. probably the coolest site in the United States. And that's a draw, isn't it? But Art, what if I told you what we're going to see the Chinese saw in 1253 and documented it on paper, and we documented it here in AGUA FRIA in Arizona? Would you say that's probably one of the an important location?
That's pretty important.
So what we're going to do is we're going to head that way. Pato's that way. We're going to head that way, and we're going to take a look and see what's out there today. And come along with this journey, and we're going to go to a pretty cool place. So I got my waters. You've got your waters. So let's go take a walk across the journey. And this hiking is the worst hiking anywhere. There's holes to fall in. There's lava rock. And, you know, you'll see cows with broken legs on occasion. I've seen it more than once out here. So even they think it's treacherous. This is going to be the last test of the bikes. I'd have to say right now that the bikes have made the test. I got to say this. There is no way in hell that an e-bike would have made that run. I don't think you'd buy an e-bike to go make that run, though. I think that's the truth of the matter is that that's some tough stuff. And again, if any manufacturer wants to challenge me on that, I'm good with that. So we're going to come up over this cliff right here, take a look. So we're going to walk down. I'll go up one more level, and then we'll start working our way down. Start looking over those right there. Okay, there we are. There's the first little section. Start to see the guy. Is he the alien? Proves that aliens were here right there. There's your alien. So let's get up here. That's supernova number two. And there's actually three of those. It's hard to see because of the sun and... But look how they pecked that in. But that's another supernova right there. There's three in this location. A supernova, I believe, was 1054. And so they were standing on this very spot to get this deer. But that's my favorite deer right there. Isn't that incredible? And there's a lot of stuff here, even on the backsides of these rocks. This would have been a special place. Very spiritual place for them. Look, here's where you can really see. Look how much time they spent on this rock. How weathered it is, and the patina's gone. This would have been someplace they would have spent a ton of time right in this area. Look at that rock right there. Then my favorite deer, the psychedelic deer. Man, you had to been really high to do that one. Or, because if you saw that spirit deer, you were going in the dark side. Look at that, isn't that crazy? This is just the start of our journey, Art. You're gonna see some shit today. There is the most famous rock in the Southwest right here. It's hard to see. Isn't that funny how you lose the light? And it's very hard to see. But that is it right there. There is, what was that? There is supernova right there. Now, if you look in a science book what a nebulous looks like, you will see that exact thing right there. You'll see that. So then you know this wasn't some illusion of somebody drawing that. That is the real deal. And we're at the worst time right now to be able to see it. But that is the most famous rock anywhere. And then if you look at that rock over there, it looks like they've got some cupola in it. I don't know for sure if that's it, but that is the most famous rock in America, in my opinion. Maybe second to Plymouth Rock, but this was way, way earlier. So... Art is making ancient shoelaces. They would have done that with a sharp piece of flint, you know, because they didn't have metal. But if you keep going, By the time you get down, it will turn in. If you see those little bitty, and that's how they would have tied a moccasin together. That would have been, that would also been what they sewed the top and the bottom moccasin piece together with. It's actually incredible.
To get to these fibers.
Yeah. The fibers then turn into strands, but they stay together, even though, you know, so they work together as one. I think I walked around there last time. It's been a long time since I've been here. This is slick stuff, though. You wouldn't want to roll, tuck and roll. Oh. Come grab this, would you? I'm not sure. Ooh, that hurt. Here. Thank you, sir. Ooh, how about another one in the leg? I didn't attract anything else. I think the duck petroglyph is right there on that. You gotta go down there and it's on that rock on this wall right there is where I think the duck's at. Famous Pado duck. That's why this is called Pado. Even though it's not spectacular, you got to see it. Nobody knows where that's at. You're in very limited company. Well, you got to go with Art to see. I wanted him to see that. I didn't want to go down and see it again, but I wanted you to see it because that's special. Now, okay, and here my theory comes because I've just evaluated all the stuff, and look at that guy right there.
That guy was in the gym.
There's the warrior right there. That's a warrior. There's not very much doubt in anybody's mind that that guy is. And he's well endowed, and he has a big stick. He's got two big sticks.
Well,
now, if you do this, what I want you to do is get your phone out.
Yeah.
And I want you to take a picture of this with your phone. And then when you get home, I want you to look at and see what you see, and you're going to shit, okay? You're going to shit. So just get a good picture of it, and then when you go home, you look at his face on there. The different things you see over here are just not the normal petroglyphs. You're starting to see things that are completely different, you know, and you're looking at this wall. And so they built this up here, which I believe was a training ground of where they learned to fight. This is what I believe. That they built this for that purpose. Because there is the, you know, anybody before, you have to go past that rock to get out here. Now, when I was over there, Art, when I was over there, I had a vision. And I was sitting over there, and I looked over here, and I had this vision of people being thrown off that cliff. The shaman's cave.
Shaman.
There it is. Ain't nobody knows where this shit's at.
Oh shit.
Go in there. Be careful. I don't think there's any snakes, but I've been in there a couple times, but you kind of got to look in there. So the shaman would have been in there. There's no doubt in my mind.
Brewing up this stuff, man.
Make sure you look at this deer on this side of this with all the dots. Okay, so this is where they used to manufacture arrows and spears. So what they would do, they would heat up the material they were using on a fire and put water in it and get steam. And the steam would start to make the material pliable. And then what they would do is straighten the arrows right here. This is pretty rare. You don't, there's another one over here somewhere. That's a pretty rare thing. You do not see that.